Hello friends, the topic is exception handling. This is very, very, very important topic. So that's, of course, that's simple. If you can listen carefully and properly, this is the topic which is applied or which will be used in the real-time projects. So any, of course, if you take any Java project, so that will be, of course, handled with the exceptions very carefully and, of course, properly. Otherwise, it leads to a lot of problems. Okay, exception handling. So very, very important topic. Very practical topic, which is applied in the real-time scenario. So what is that? Let's go with the concept, of course. Okay, yes. So see here, any program will have two types of errors, basically. Compile time errors and runtime errors. Compile time errors means the errors due to the syntax. Okay, so you know the syntax, like if you miss any comma or a space or a semicolon, or you know the physical alignment, if you have any sort of lapse, then it leads to compile time errors. That's something about compile errors. But runtime errors can be, you can just see the slide here. It is, you know, for example, 1/0. Actually, it is infinity, which is not defined in the computer. So if at all the processor gets some value by zero, it was not defined for a processor. Then the processor cannot understand what to do there. So that's an exception. So at that type of scenarios, please understand, the system may terminate out of the program, or at times it may crash the system also. Please understand, it may terminate out of the program. See, for example, some application is running. Imagine any ATM or any railway reservation system or any airport reservation system, anything, you know, a continuous thing which should be there 24/7. But if any, for any exception, if it is not handled properly, if it terminates out of the program, you know, the end users will face a lot of problem. And of course, it leads to a lot of credibility will be, you know, it leads to very bad credibility. So please understand, if you terminate the program or even the system may crash also. So please understand, if you terminate out of the program, let me just tell you. So some programs, for example, it may run for a very long time. Big institutes or people with the cancer research or research on the cells or research on the big data, like, you know, the program may be running for a very long time. So if it is running for example, 1 year, at the end, for example, after 365 days, at the last 10 minutes, if something is not handled properly, if it terminates, please understand what is the scenario there. What is the fate of the programmers? What is the fate of the complete organization expectation? Please understand this very important topic. So all the exceptions should be handled very carefully, very properly. We need to anticipate everything. Please understand, very important topic I'm telling you, my dear friends. Okay. So the runtime errors called 1/0 or array index out of bounds. There is an array only size of 5. But by mistake, the programmer may not be knowing it. The sixth value we want to insert. So where is that? There is a space of only 5. Stack overflow, the same. Okay. So if there is a stack of only a limited size, but you are still trying to push some value, assigning one type of value to another type of variable, integer value, you want to put it in a string variable or the vice versa. So it is a number mismatch. So for the runtime errors, of course, it leads to some exceptions. The system can't understand what to do there. So we need to handle it properly. Otherwise, it terminates or it may crash the system also. So that's why we need to handle it properly. And how? Let's see here. So you can see here, we'll have the try mechanism and the catch mechanism. All the basic code where we are anticipating the actual main code will be kept in the try block. Please understand, my dear friends. So all the main code will come under try block. Because any sort of errors or any sort of runtime errors or any sort of exceptions, yes, we may anticipate something there. So that should be in the try block. So then from the try block, if any exception raises, if the system raises any exception from there, it goes to the catch blocks, multiple catch blocks. Actually, I've shown only one catch block here, multiple catch blocks. So depending on, for example, if it is a arithmetic exception, it will go to arithmetic exception. If it is array index out of bounds, it go to array index out of bound exception, the next catch block, of course. If it is a number mismatch, it will go to that exception. If it is stack overflow, it will go to that exception. And of course, it should be properly, we should deal it. And so the corresponding n number of catch blocks will be there. So all the main code should be in the try block, and we'll have the multiple catch blocks. And then this is the actual correcting code. We may, you've taken like this, we may correct it. So the corrective code is something after the catch blocks. So this is the try catch mechanism to handle the exceptions. So now let us understand very fast here. So we got a is equal to 10, b is equal to 5, and c is equal to 5. And then of course we have some variables x and y. So x is equal to a by b minus c. So a is 10, b minus c is 5 minus 5, which is 0. 10 by 0. 1 by 0. The processor can't understand. So then, it leads to an ambiguous situation. Then an exception will be raised by the Java system. So it will check for the catch block now. It is an arithmetic exception or division by 0. Will come under arithmetic exception. So it will check for arithmetic exception. So from here, it will go to arithmetic exception. Then some code is given, which is system.out.println division by 0 happened. Good. So it is properly handled. And then the correcting code. Yeah, so instead of going for B minus C, A by, it is they've corrected it. If at all something comes like that, we may just modify it for some set of values, for certain values. A by B plus C, it is the corrective code. So which is 10 by 10, which is 1. So I want to print the value of system.out.println, which is y is equal to the value of y. So in the classes, was ended. Okay, so like this, please understand exception handling is very important. All the main code, the anticipating code will be in the try block. We'll have multiple catch blocks and then the correcting code. So like that it follows. So let's execute the program. So yes, this is the actual code. You can see there, the same code I've just dumped it. So actually it should throw an exception, but we have handled it. So what should happen there? It will print. Yeah, so see here. So A is equal to B minus C, X is equal to A by B minus C. It is 1 by 0 error. Go to arithmetic exception. So it prints exception division by 0. See exception division by 0. Then the corrective code is A by B plus C, that is 10 by 10. So Y is equal to 1. So it is printing Y is equal to 1 safely. And just come out of the program in a very safe zone, in a very safe manner, so without crashing the system or without terminating the program abruptly, not in the middle. So after completion, we just came out. Okay. So hope you understood, very important concept. Yes. If you like it, subscribe and like it, and then share it. And then please comment if you have any doubts. Thank you for your patient listening. Have a good day. See you all. Bye-bye.